Hello, welcome to the video tutorial on creating a Mikrotik router in Windows Hyper-V. In this video I create a virtual Mikrotik router that has both a WAN interface and a LAN interface. After completing the creation of the virtual router, I configured the Windows computer connected via the LAN interface to connect to the internet. Let's get started. First I went to the Mikrotik homepage and downloaded the image file of the Mikrotik router for Hyper-V hypervisor. You can not only install Mikrotik on Hyper-V but you can install it on VirtualBox or VMware. In the Hyper-V hypervisor I created a new virtual switch named WAN. Virtual switch helps Mikrotik router connect to the internet. Next I used the newly downloaded image file to create a Mikrotik virtual machine. I created a new virtual machine named Mikrotik. This virtual machine has 1 GB of memory and connects to a virtual switch called WAN. I then used the image file downloaded in the previous step as the hard drive for the Mikrotik virtual machine. I have finished creating the Mikrotik virtual machine, now I start it to check the results. Next I downloaded software called WinBox from the Mikrotik homepage to connect to the virtual machine. After downloading WinBox to my computer, I used it to connect to the Mikrotik virtual machine. You allow WinBox to go through the Windows firewall. On WinBox I connected the Mikrotik router using the MAC address. Successful connection, Mikrotik asks you to create a login password. So I have completed creating the Mikrotik virtual machine on Hyper-V, but this router only has a single interface. A physical router has at least 2 interfaces, so I will add a new interface for Mikrotik. In Hyper-V I created a new virtual switch. This virtual switch helps the Mikrotik router connect to computers on the local network. I created a new virtual switch named LAN. After completing the creation of the virtual switch, open the Mikrotik virtual machine settings and add a new interface to it. I added a new network adapter for the Mikrotik virtual machine. Mikrotik's new interface connects to a virtual switch called LAN. Now the Mikrotik virtual machine has 2 interfaces and connects to 2 different networks. Again I used WinBox connected to the Mikrotik router. Use the administrator password just created in the previous step to log in to the router. These are 2 interfaces on the Mikrotik router. Next I quickly set up the router to connect it to the internet. I set up the WAN interface in dynamic mode. I then set up addressing for the local network. Don't forget to set up a DHCP server to assign IP addresses to computers on the local network. You enable NAT to allow computers on the local network to connect to the internet. I changed the DNS addresses allocated to computers connected to the interface called LAN. Above are the basic configuration steps for Mikrotik routers, which are similar to physical devices. To test the internet connection from within the local network, I created a new Windows virtual machine. This virtual machine connects to the Mikrotik router via LAN interface. The purpose of this video is to introduce how to create a Mikrotik virtual machine, so I will fast forward how to create a Windows virtual machine. Above are step-by-step instructions on how to create a Mikrotik virtual machine in Windows Hyper-V. Thank you for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe. This is a Windows virtual machine after completing the operating system installation. This virtual machine connects to the Mikrotik router via an interface called LAN, so it is allocated an IP address from the DHCP server. Also, it can connect to the internet via Mikrotik router. So you have a virtual router that looks like a physical device. Good luck.